Hello everybody, DZ for you today with another 7 Deadly Sins Grand Cross video. Today's topic, the Blue Slater. Let's go! So, first of all, his passive. An opening. Yeah, if the enemy has an empty ult gauge bar, so he increases his crit chance by 3 times, 300% of the value you actually got. So if you get like 33% crit chance, his base crit chance is actually 39%. That's his base crit chance. And yeah, so if you hit an enemy with deplete ult gauge bar, you guaranteed to crit. But we have to debunk this. It's basically impossible to use this passive in PvP, because if you're going first, the enemy automatically get one ult gauge bar. So either you bring an ult gauge orb reduction like Merlin or Helbrim, or this passive doesn't even apply at all. So in PvP he's really useless, or when the enemy gets the first turn, so they all like get the ult bar filled like anyway because they use skills. So in passive and PvP you can ignore this passive at all. It never applies, he's never seen in PvP, so yeah, forgot about him in this place. Where he really shine is Red Demon. It's a free-to-play option in the beginning part of the game. I use him really often there, so he's decent there. That's his only place to be in my opinion, but he's outshined by even other free-to-play options like Redless Hawk. She does way more damage than him, and yeah. So his first skill, Iron Slash. It's server damage, so server does increase his crit chance by the double, and when you get him like 50% crit chance, yeah, you guaranteed to crit the Red Demon. I just will talk about the Red Demon because you can use him everywhere, but Red Demon is the common place to be for this unit. Yeah, 160 single target damage, 240 and 400. Yeah, 400. So, single target hit. So, his second skill is Sawblade. It's 220 single target damage and then remove stances. That's important. If you don't freeze the Red Demon, he gets in stance. And yeah, removing the stance is important because the stance is increasing the Red Demon's stats. Yeah. So, and the 220 damage as well, so the damage does not increase. And disable stances skills, so the Red Demon won't get the stance up in the next turn. And this just increases to 2 turns and 360 damage, so yeah. His ultimate is Overpower. Basically, the Red Slater's second skill is also Overpower, but you can name the different skills the same name, so whatever. It's a single target nuke and infects damage, so this means the enemy can't recover for 2 turns. And yeah, with Simon as a spirit link, you can get like 630 damage. That's it for Blue Slater. How do you build him? Like maybe triple crit damage sets if you got them from the PvP rewards, or just basically attack defense. Yeah, that's it. Nothing special, and thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Bye.